Performing since he was five, and dancing for just about anyone who would want to watch.
He has been seen recently on Disney commercials and several independent films. Yes. Has a new feature film coming out soon.
Yeah, maybe we'll talk about that with us. Yes, so let's go bring him on. Here's Matthew. Woo! How are you doing today?
I'm doing fantastic. Thank you for having me on the show.
Yeah, no problem. Yes.
All right. Would you like to tell us about where you're from and how long you've been up here?
Yeah.
Well, I'm originally from Houston, Texas. I know it's hard to believe you can't hear my accent. I got rid of it. We moved here about a year ago, so I had to lose the y'alls and the fixin' too, so I got rid of that. But,
we got several friends who do that.
Oh, yeah.
Who are from the South, who all do the y'all, and, yeah.
It's hard to get rid of, but...
Yeah, it's yeah.
But,
I'm glad you quit.
Oh, yeah. It was tough. It was tough. I had to wear some patches.
It was strong.
Yeah.
So. I don't know. How are you? Okay. I don't know.
I'm great, Joey. I'm great.
What?
The second time.
You're a singer.
I am.
Yes. And what kind of music is your style?
My style of music is really, you wouldn't look at me and say, oh yeah, that guy sings that kind of music. I like to sing more of like the R&B, kind of like Usher, Chris Brown, Michael Jackson type of stuff. Not usually, but I really like to sing anything like John Mayer, Jason Mraz, I love all of them too. So I have a pretty broad.
Okay, you can do just about anything.
I like to think so. Just kidding. No, but I really do. I love pretty much sing anything that sounds good to me. I enjoy singing. So.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay, so let's see. Why did you come out to, you know, this crazy messed up place? I'm kidding.
Well, when I was younger, I watched, you know, some TV shows, and I was like, man, I like the way that they make me laugh. I love like laughing. So I was like, you know, I want to try to get into that stuff. So when sixth grade is like the first year of my school that you can like get into theater. So I was like, okay, I want to try that. So did theater in sixth, seventh, and eighth grade. And I was like, you know, I really like film, so I'm going to try to get into that. So I started studying in Houston with an acting coach. And I was like, I really love this. This is what I want to do. So she's like, send me out to LA, got a manager and agent. And that's kind of how it all started. But I really enjoy it. This is my passion. I love it every day, waking up and knowing, okay, go on this audition and doing stuff like that. So it was a long process, but I'm here now and I'm enjoying the heck out of it. So.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
And let's see, who are your favorite actors? Like, who inspires you in acting and as well as singing?
My favorite actors probably have to be Shia LaBeouf and Will Smith, my two main ones, because you know they started out in like sitcoms and you watch them grow as far as doing big films they do now. I love Robert Downey Jr. as well. I respect him a lot. Everything he's been through and coming a long way.
Yeah.
And singers, like I said, Michael Jackson and Usher and Chris Brown. I love the way that they, I don't know, they really put themselves into their music, and I think that's really cool. You like see who they really are whenever they perform and stuff, and I want to be like that. So they inspire me, and I want to inspire other people to be that way too. You know. Like Will Smith and Shia LaBeouf, they made me laugh, and I love making people laugh. It makes me, you know, it makes me feel good, and knowing that I help them, you know, feel better, whatever they're going through. So that's what I want to do, is inspire other kids to follow their dreams the way they did to me. So,
Well, awesome. Okay.
Yeah.
So,
and yeah. Now you do dance as well, mm-hmm. and we have a little clip here of you dancing.
Yeah.
So we're gonna go ahead and show that to everyone at the watching right now. Yes. For saying awesome too much. I don't get it.
Awesome. There's nothing wrong with the word awesome. I say
it's
all the
time. Awesome
wear
is,
it, out.
It makes the world go
around. It's my middle
round,
name.
Honestly.
Just kidding. It's not my middle name.
But that would be cool, though.
That would be cool.
It would
I'm
be awesome.
My kids that.
It's a little far, but I'm, you know, that's, it's, yeah, it's what it is.
Yeah.
So, yes.
What can you do?
Yeah.
Awesome, yeah.
There's a question.
No word. Okay. So, if you would work with anybody, like anybody in the world, like the fan right there, or the sky up there.
Sky.
Who would
you
work with?
This cup.
Oh, yes, the cup.
It's a very beautiful cup.
It is. I made it myself. Just kidding. If I could work with anybody, I'd probably have to say Shia LaBeouf. We look so much alike. I'm just kidding. We have the same hair. So, I don't know. I thought I could be a stunt devil.
Yeah.
I don't know any stunts. I don't know why I said that. But, no, Shia LaBeouf, Will Smith, like, I don't know. If I worked with them,
yeah.
I would absolutely...
Yeah, they're both very cool guys.
I'd have, I would have trouble doing scenes with them without passing out or peeing my pants.
You could do that, too. You'd just, like, you'd, like, in the middle of the scene, be like, oh, can I just leave?
They're like, cut Matthew Peter's pants again. Gosh, dang it.
It's a nightmare to work with.
This guy's got too many pair of pants he's got to change into. Whole budget's gonna be
yeah, everyone's. You're gonna be the biggest expense. Everyone's buying pants for you.
I will be, and I'm only a stunt double.
Yeah,
that makes sense.
So, have you seen that new Transformers movie?
I have seen every single one of them because obviously Shia LaBeouf is my favorite actor. So
yeah,
I went out of my way to see each one of them. I can't wait till the third one comes out on DVD. I'm really excited mm-hmm. about that. Mm-hmm.
I like the second one the best.
You like the second one?
Second one's pretty funny.
It's like the two twin ice cream trucks or something.
Oh yeah, yeah, they're
really
funny.
Funny.
They were funny. But I can't figure out which one I like the most because they're all. Mm-hmm. No, I feel like they kept getting better and better.
I know.
The third one was so
huge.
Yeah, it
was epic.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
There's a whole lot of different, like, machines this time in the third
yeah.
one. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Came out of nowhere. But
yeah.
It was great. I love Shia LaBeouf. They say that I saw this interview somewhere that Shia LaBeouf, like, they say that Shia LaBeouf interacts with those machines the best, even though, like, there's no machine there when you're doing the
yeah.
scene, so he's, like, interacting with nothing, so he's, like, he's got a big imagination, I'm guessing. So,
yeah.
But I think that's pretty cool that he can do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, awesome.
Yeah. So,
that word again.
Okay.
Awesome. Can't get rid of it. It's following us.
Awesome.
So
what do you like to do in your spare time?
Man, my spare time. When I do have spare time, I enjoy to play basketball at the apartment complex that I stay at.
Cool.
I like to play guitar. Yeah, play guitar, play piano. They have a piano there, so
mm-hmm.
I rarely have time because everybody's using the piano. So.
Yeah.
Last night I actually played. I had enough time. I was like, yes, I'm going to take advantage of this. It was late. I was probably waking up the whole pot of complex, but I didn't care. I need my piano time, so. But.
You got to get it in there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Got to get it in there.
Play any drums at all?
Oh, I don't, but my best friend does, one of my best friends, so.
That's cool.
Sometimes I'll get on his drum, but I'm like, he's like, dude, you're disgracing my drum right now. You're not doing well. So I let him with the drums. It's not my thing. But yeah, in my spare time, That's what I do. Watch TV, just veg out sometimes after a long day. I end up napping, and then I can't sleep because I nap. So.
So you got a very complicated day.
I am a complicated man.
It's all over the place. Yeah. It's yeah.
It's curly hair. Yeah. It's just like my head.
Curly hair is
just complicated. It's stuff going everywhere.
Yeah. So, anyway, back on topic here, you just did a film called The Preacher's Daughter.
Yes.
Can you tell us about, without, you know, giving away too much, tell us about it or some, you know, onset stories or whatever,
yeah,
you know, whatever you want to share.
So, I know what it's about. It's about a preacher's daughter.
No, it's actually about the daughter of a preacher.
Too close. You were close.
So close. Sorry. No, but it was actually shot... in a town probably about 15 to 20 minutes away from where I'm actually from. So it was kind of cool to shoot back in Texas, so that was cool.
Yeah.
The lead actress, Andrea Bowen, is on Desperate Housewives. Mm-hmm. She plays Terry Hatcher's daughter on the show. And that was cool to like be in that with her. She is the main character, like I said already, I'm rambling. She has these flashbacks.
It's the Matthew show.
It is. Joey Elise. No, but she has these flashbacks, and I'm playing a teenage boy, and I'm actually asking for a cigarette, but I don't do that. That's bad. That's very bad. Very bad.
Don't do drugs.
It was fun. She wasn't like a prima donna or anything. She was actually really, you know, she's a respectable girl. She actually, I spent a lot of time talking with her. I didn't think that she would, you know, so I figured she'd be like, oh, no, I'm too good for you. But no, she was actually very nice. She talked to me a lot, and the director, Michelle Mower, she is from Friendswood, my actual hometown. So I thought that was cool. Like shared that, but she was really nice. The whole cast was nice. They went out of your way to help you. Went and got Starbucks, so I had a first coffee there. So that was cool. Also, didn't sleep after that. But
I bet. Yeah, you're probably pretty.
I was pretty wired. I was wired. But
playing some of that piano at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, singing loud. But that was fun. That was that was a great experience. Great experience.
Cool.
So
very awesome. And we actually have some pictures of you on the set and some awesome stuff.
Okay, I was gonna say not those. Just kidding. No, but yeah.
Yeah. So let's go ahead and show those. Pictures. Now tell us more about the whole filming and everything.
Well, I can't really give away too much. I don't want to give away the whole film. But,
I understand.
Because it's illegal. let's see. When I was there, it was very, very hot. Obviously, it was Texas, so you got to be used to that. But it was so much fun. Man, what is there to talk about? There's so many, I can't even think.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, how can I forget this? Okay, so my scene, like I said, I wanted a cigarette, which is very bad, by the way. They're like, okay. She's like, she came up to me, Michelle Moore. She's like, okay, so you're gonna light this cigarette and smoke it. And I was like, huh? She's like, yeah, you're gonna smoke it. I was like, well, I've never smoked before. Obviously, I don't plan to. She's like, okay. It's like, I kind of feel bad. I'm teaching a little kid how to smoke. I'm like, all right, fine. So I'll do it. It's for the role. So the whole cast is around, and it's kind of a close shot, so they were like kind of close, so... put the cigarette in, and I was dreading it. I was like, oh, God, this is going to be terrible. So you had to puff while you light, apparently. Mm-hmm. So I did that, and my line right after is, yeah, it should be pretty cool. So I did that, and I got this huge, just terrible. And I go, yeah, it should be pretty cool. And the entire cast just died laughing. I was embarrassed. I was like, just give me a second. I got to cough this off. So it was terrible.
Don't they have those like fake ones or whatever that like
they
have
should
the stuff
wouldn't you think so for the sake of my lungs for God's sake. No, but
and then
everybody died laughing at Michelle, and I was like, okay, well, you're not gonna smoke it, just walk off with it, we're gonna assume that you have light. I was like, okay, thank goodness, because Wow, that was terrible. I had that taste in my mouth for like 2 days.
Oh, gosh.
It was terrible.
But, I can imagine. Oh, man.
It gave me the desire to not ever smoke, so that was probably a good thing.
Yeah.
Okay, so. Get off of that subject.
Yeah, let's get off. I am, actually. I support a lot of charities. One of my best buddies, he has a kidney disease called IgA nephropathy, and I support that because, you know, it's my best buddy, so I wouldn't want anything to happen to him, so I'm trying to support that so they can find a cure. And this other one, I have another good friend of mine who has juvenile diabetes, so I go on the walks that they have and stuff for... JDRF, I believe, is the name. I could have butchered that, but you got the right idea. And I also, back in Friendswood, in Texas, I support this, it's like Special Olympics. I'm involved in that. I help the kids with special needs, and they play baseball and soccer and swimming. So that's definitely, it's a lot of fun. I have a lot of friends that go to my high school that are very special to me and very dear to my heart, so I help them out. It's a great feeling, you know, so, because... us as actors, we're blessed with a lot of opportunities to come here and follow our dreams, and some people aren't as blessed. So we're giving back to them, so it's a great feeling, and it's a great thing to see the joy in their faces when we do so. So that's a lot of fun.
And we're involved with family and children kind of charities called Starlight Children's Foundation.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
It helps six families to really get away and have fun and just have fun and forget about all that stuff, and it raises money to cure it, and it's great. I love it. Yeah. I love spending time with the kids and just
absolutely.
It's a lot of fun, seeing really their faces is. And it's
that's awesome.
So aside from that, do you have any goals that are either short term or long term or acting.
Tomorrow.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Catch up on my sleep.
Let's do lunch.
Yeah, let's do lunch. Do another show. Let's just get out of here. I'm hungry. No. My short term goals will probably be starting out. I want to book a couple guest stars on sitcoms or dramas. Either way, that's what I want to start out with, and then just grow.
Yeah.
And my long term goals would be book a series regular or a lead role on a sitcom or what have you, or a lead role in a movie. That would be great. That's my goal is to get to that point, like Shia LaBeouf start out in sitcoms and then
work his way.
Yeah, that's what I want to do. I want to be. I thought that was cool how he did that. So you could like watch him grow as an actor and as a person. So that's what I want to do.
Yeah.
How about you? What are some of your goals?
I don't know. Oh man, I don't like this reversing stuff, man.
I'm sorry. I'm reversing the game upon you. Making it the Matthew show.
Well, I don't know. I kind of, you know, I've gotten, you know, a few like guest star roles and. I don't know, I like doing that because it's just, it's a good way to start off and then recurring, you know, keep doing it. I guess the next goal would be to get, like a series regular on a show and, like, be, you know, a regular on it and keep doing that. But, yeah, my main goal would be to get, you know, a lead role in a feature film, go to the Oscars, and, yeah, that's the goal anyway.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's kind of far-fetched, but that's the goal.
No, you can accomplish anything as long as you believe in yourself. That's what I live by. If I believe in myself. Well, I don't know why I held that up. It doesn't make any sense. It does nothing for me. Nothing doesn't make me any more powerful.
It's the image that, you know, it kind of ties it all together.
Yeah. It really does. Every intelligent man has
a cup.
What
are your goals, Elise?
About that fan mail? Let's see, where?
What are your goals? You can't just go on. My goals are okay with fan mail. Share it with us, Elise. Are your goals? Are they secret? Are we gonna...
Well, she likes to draw. She, you an artist?
Yeah, you can
be
an artist.
I like that.
She's very modest. Very
is
modest.
Is it hot in here or what?
I know, I'm sorry. I'm just kidding. I'm not that. Thank you for those. Somebody got that.
Okay, so. So
we're rambling.
At least you were going to say fan mail. You did say fan mail.
Yeah.
Are you going to talk about some fan mail?
So, where should people send fan mail?
Hate mail. I'll probably get more hate mail than fan mail. My fan mail you can send to my manager, Brilliant Talent Management. You can send it to them. If hate or fan mail, I'll accept you graciously.
Good
hopefully good. Hopefully good. But yeah, that's where you send it. Send them all.
Send everything.
Yeah.
Hopefully no underwear. That'd be kind of awkward.
It would be. I've never heard of anybody getting underwear in their fan mail.
Yeah.
You never know.
I can imagine, though.
All right. Joe and Elise show. Getting a little awkward here.
Okay. So, let's set that aside.
So, okay.
Please.
So, we were just before the show, we were talking about how we were talking about the shuffle. Dancing, and we were talking about the shuffle, how you just learned it.
Just
and I just learned it as well. So, we were actually... Right now, we're going to demonstrate for you the shuffle.
Let's
and
do it.
Just show it off. Ready?
If you can pick this up, anybody at home, if you can pick this up, it's great exercise. You want to lose weight, I suggest just putting on the music and doing this, because I sweat profusely every time I do this. It's great exercise. It's kind of sad, because I do a dance, and I'm like, oh, God. I'm dead afterwards.
I'm scared to do it now. All right, let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
I don't care. You don't even care.
No.
Wait, look, say this question.
Let me be.
Alright.
Hey, what's up?
This is Joey and Elise from the Joey and Elise Show. Yeah. So we're going to tell you guys if, you know, for all of you guys who want to send us, you know, to criticize the show, please send your comments to www.whatswrongwithyou, who do you think you are, I don't even care, I bet you couldn't even think two words in a row, at youarenotasimportantasme.com.
But for all of you who would like to compliment and support our show, please send your comments to the Joey Elise Show at AOL.com. Thank you.
What?
Hi, I'm Joey.
Okay.
That's Joey.
I don't know. So anyway, our guest next time is going to be Taylor Beckett. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be exciting.
It's going to be
exciting.
What are you doing? What are you doing? I don't know what she's up to.
I'm Joey.
She's... Yeah, and I'm Elise.
I'm ready for Taylor.
That's good. Well, anyway, please stick around, and we are going to show you Taylor Beckett next time. And I guess stay cool.
I'm Joey.
And don't forget to send us any comments or fan mail at joeyandeliseshow@aol.com.
That was my line.
But I'm Joey.